Vince, did you know tonight's show is brought to you by McDonald's Family Restaurants?
Of course I did.
Oh, good.
Isn't this a beaut? Hello, everybody.
Hi.
Hello, everybody at home. You know what I'm sitting in? This is a replica of the very first motor car ever made. Only had three wheels. It's like the one I've got now, actually. It's only got three wheels. It did a fantastic speed. It drove up to 15 miles per hour. Very fast. A terrific little engine. It was made by Mercedes-Benz, by Mr. Benz. And he did a good job too. You could still putt along with this one, couldn't you?
Yeah.
You know, what size do you think the longest car in the world is right now? You got any idea? Would you believe that there is a car that is 100 feet long and it actually lives in Western Australia? And we've got some footage of it here, and it's the most incredible car you've ever seen. It's got a hot tub inside it. It's got a swimming pool and a putting green. There it is. Look at the wheels. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. And that's just the back section. Here comes the rest of the car.
Oh.
Isn't that huge? It's nearly as big as an aeroplane. That's it. We're going to take a look inside it now. Look at that. And then inside it's got its own theaterette. That's a theater. And it's got a putting green if you play golf. A swimming pool. This is inside a car. Can you believe it? And a hot tub. There it is. Magnificent motor car. It's worth $500,000. And not only that, but it's got a four-poster bed inside it as well. Just incredible, in case you want to have a little bit of a snooze. And here comes the world's smallest car, made by Ferrari. Here it comes, and Joey D is driving it. Go, Joey. Here he comes. Put it in gear. What a beauty. It's got the engine in the back.
Yep.
Well, anybody want to go for a ride with Joey?
Yeah.
Go on, you can hop in.
Oh, no.
As you said, it's a car show tonight, and we've got a real ripper program for you. So come on, baby, drive my car.
She wrote it to me. She said, baby, can't you see?
Redhead up there in the middle. What a gorgeous looking girl. Hello, sweetheart. What's your name? What's her name?
Lee.
Lee. Liam. Ah, and that, now you're, oh, I see. The Liam's down, the brother downstairs who doesn't like his sister getting all the attention. Hello, Claire. You're a beautiful girl. There's a very, very big week this week for an excited young boy from Tasmania. Because it's Mark's last show next week, because as you all know, he's going into Neighbours, which we're very excited about. And Mark comes from Tassie.
Yes.
And during the week, another young man came over from Tassie. As a matter of fact, we had a camera there when he arrived. A very exciting moment. The Abel Tasman, which you came over on as well.
Right.
We've got some footage of it right here, I think.
Loved it.
Here it is. That's the Abel Tasman, and a very excited young boy arrived on the mainland Australia, and there he is. And that's the face you're going to be seeing on Young Talent Time for the next few years. Because that's the face of Jamie Churchill. And I think his car is just about arriving in the studio, so go and welcome him, kids. Because it is a brand new team member we're welcoming tonight, and please, Australia, make him very, very welcome. For the first time on our show, here's Jamie Churchill!
Who's that lady?
Take a deep breath now. So what do you reckon? Yeah, I reckon too. You're going to be great. You have a good trip over?
Yeah.
You're over your nerves now?
Yeah.
Real man's man, young Jamie. Real tough kid from Tassie. Yeah? Well, that's always the hardest one, that very first one, Jamie. And we're really, really happy to have you here. And your mum, where's Janine? Where are you, Nini? Give her a round of applause too. Welcome to our madhouse. Gorgeous lady too, and a very important part of our stuff. Well, of course you know, Jamie, that when you're on Young Talent Time, you've got to learn to sing and you've got to learn to dance and you've got to learn to do all that sort of stuff and act a little bit too. And unfortunately or fortunately, whichever way you want to look at it, you've got to have a partner as well. Now, this doesn't mean anything romantic or anything, but your partner is Ricky Arnott. Do they look good together? Get that over and done with, okay, and then come out fighting over there on your rostrum because you got to sing a song together as your partners, hey? Give them a round of applause, Jamie and Ricky, and here they go. Creative, isn't it? Green tires.
Green.
Green tires. Isn't that a fantastic bike?
Green.
Everybody loves bikes. Boys and girls like bikes. And before, because we're doing a segment on bikes now, before we do it, I want to tell all the boys and girls that regardless of what you do, whenever you go out on your bike, you've got to wear your helmet.
Yep. Yep.
Right?
Yep.
Promise me? Promise me you'll do that? Stack hat. Put it on. Promise? Good. Okay. Hey, you want to see somebody ride a bike? Really? Oh, thanks a lot. Is that cute?
It's a pink one.
It's your colour, John.
Yeah, it's a pink one. It matches my eyeballs, doesn't it? I'd like to show you a young man who's in our studio right now. His name's Trevor Wang, and he can ride a BMX bike like you've never seen in your life. Where are you, Trevor? Come on, where you go? Here it goes. Oh, he's a little bit slow. Come on, mate, get in your... But he's still putting his stack hat on. He was listening to me, wasn't he?
Yeah, it's a real helmet.
See, it's a real helmet. He thought he wouldn't have to use it in the studio, but here he goes. Yeah. Give him a clap. Here comes Strato. What a beauty.
Yes.
That's great stuff, Trevor. And I tell you, that's not easy to do on a studio floor. Can you do walking the dog? Oh, no, that's a yo-yo, isn't it? Okay, anybody here in the audience that can ride a bike? Really good rider. Anybody here in the audience that would like to ride a bike and that doesn't have a bike? Who in the audience that doesn't have a bike? Really seriously, who doesn't have a bike? A young boy? How about on the other side? Anybody over that side that doesn't have a bike? Hang on to that for me. Come, follow me, folks. I think there's a couple over here. We've got a couple over here. Yes? This one? Can you ride a bike? Do you have a bike? You've got a bike.
In the black.
Have you got a bike? You don't. Come with me. Are we matched, both of us? Because I tell you what we're going to do. Would you like to win a bike on Young Talent Time?
Yes.
You saw the bike that I was riding before. Well, that's a boy's bike, but I think we've got a girl's one too. A BMX bike, which is a beautiful one. All you have to do is pick one of our two Young Talent Team boys. Come on here, Mark and Vinny. They're going to be riding these bikes. We've got a... Yes, on you go, guys.
Sorry.
Hop on. Now, you have to pick which one of the boys is the fastest bike rider. Is it Vinny, and Vinny belongs to this side, or is it Mark, and Mark belongs to that side? So you ready? Which side do you reckon, folks? Is it this side, Vinny? Or is it Mark? Okay, what's your name?
Natalie.
Natalie, which one do you pick?
Mark.
Mark, okay. Well, yours is Mark. Okay, we're all ready to go. You can start.
Can we fit
just one? Yeah, just once around. First one past. The red one belongs to Mark, yes? Is the red one Mark's? This is white. This one's Mark. Mark is on white and Vinny is on red. Okay, ready, set, go! Yes, Vinny is leading. Vinny is in the lead. But Mark is catching up. Yes, Mark has now got in the front. Go, Mark. Mark is in front by 0.7 seconds. Will it be Vinny or will it be Mark? Yes! Fantastic. Well, congratulations, Vinny. You can tell everybody at school that you came second on a bike race at Young Talent Time. And Natalie, Mark, give Mark a big hug and a big kiss because you're the winner! And here comes the bike which Johnny Print is going to bring in. There you go, sweetheart. And you can take that home with the compliments of Young Talent Time. And we're really very happy to swap it for a girl's bike so you can have a really good time. And thanks for being part of the fun. That's a surprise, isn't it? Never know what can happen on Young Talent Time. Yeah. Thanks to our two terrific bike riders here. And now, let's get on the push bike and do some push bike songing. rather sudden end, wasn't it? Which my point, did you notice something about that, though? Even though that was fun and in the park, they weren't wearing their stack hats.
Naughty.
Okay, have you had a look at some of these other bikes that I've got over here? Look at this. This is a beauty, isn't it? This is what's called a penny farthing bike. And... No? Are you game? Come on, Johnny Print. Come over here and hold it for me and I'll hop on. And if I fall... Ow! Oh! See, what a look. Is that a good look? Nara, how do I get off? Because I can't see a thing. That's a penny farthing bike. And they were called penny farthings because in the old time, when I was a little kid, we didn't have dollars and cents. We used to have pennies and half pennies. And then a half of a half penny was a farthing. Or was a farthing a half a penny? Farthing was a half penny? I thought so. No? That was a halfpenny, that's right. What was a farthing?
Quarter.
What was a farthing, huh? What was it? It was a half a penny, that's right. And look at this one here, which Greg can ride. What a beauty.
Skate
park. Go on.
Oh, no.
Go on. Can you do it? Give him a drum roll, somebody. Here we go. All together. Young Talent Time, look at bikes. And for the future, as we go out, we take a look at a high-tech bike which I saw at Expo that's just absolutely fantastic. Have a little look at this one. Young Talent Time returns with more special fun right after this little break. Good break, hey? Okay, it's time to clean the cars out at the car wash with the Talent Team.
Just hanging around. I love cars and bikes.
Yeah? Do you like sitting in the car when it goes to the car wash?
Oh, sure do, yeah. What's all the bubbles and soap and water going everywhere and those big monsters' hairy legs that swish around the car? Oh, it's great fun. There's only one problem.
What's that, Clancy?
I was in a convertible with the roof down.
I hate that.
Oh, so do I. I'm sure I've shrunk. But I'm nice and clean behind the ears.
Oh, that's good. Clancy, why are you wearing that hat?
Oh, I'm a part-time chauffeur.
A chauffeur? Yeah. Wow, you must meet lots of amazing people.
Oh, sure do. I nearly drove for Michael Jackson when he was out here.
Really? What do you mean, nearly?
Well, I would have driven him if I'd been working that day.
Clancy, I don't think you've had anybody interesting in your car.
Oh, yes, I have. Yeah, there was this guy called Fred. Now, let me tell you about Fred. Now, Fred was a friend of mine, and he used to have all the girls all the time, and the poor man, I just sat in the front. Three little girls sitting in the back seat, hugging and a kissing with Fred. I said, why don't one of you come up and sit beside me? And this is what the three girls said.
All together now, one, two, three. Keep your mind on your driver, keep your hands on the wheel. Keep your snoopy eyes on the road ahead. We're having fun, sitting in the back seat, kissing and a hugging with Fred.
I said, how do you like my triple carburetor? And all of them whispered low.
All together now, one, two, three. Keep your mind on your driver, keep your hands on the wheel. Keep your snoopy eyes on the road ahead. We're having fun, sitting in the back seat, kissing and a hugging with Fred.
All of them in love with Fred. Kissing and a hugging with Fred. Wish that I could be like Fred.
My mum drives like lightning.
You mean she goes very fast?
No, she's always striking trees. Hi, Juanita.
Hi, Greg.
Juanita, what's the worst type of driving school?
I don't know. What is the worst type of driving school?
One that offers a crash course.
That's cute, a crash course. Okay, crash course in joke telling. Stand up, stand up. What's your name?
Len.
Len, what's your giggle for everybody throughout Australia, Len?
What do you get if you cross an elephant and a kangaroo?
I don't know. What do you get if you cross an elephant and a kangaroo?
Big holes in Australia.
Clever. Oh, look, here you go. Can you sing? There's a young talent time microphone for you and you can have a lot of fun with that. Okay, young lady. What's your name?
Avril.
Avril? Show us a big smile first. That's what a girl. Okay, tell me your giggle.
What witch do you find in a desert?
What witch do you find in a desert?
A sandwich.
You painted every car in Australia pink.
Every car pink in Australia.
Yeah.
I don't know. What would you get?
A pink carnation.
I've heard that one before, but it's funny. And what's your name, sweetheart?
Alexandra.
Oh, Alexandra, you got beautiful beads around your neck. Where'd you get them from?
I've forgotten.
Oh, you've forgotten. Did your mummy buy them for you?
I think so.
Oh, good. Okay. Well, you tell everybody your giggle, Alexandra.
What is the last thing you take off before you go to bed?
What is the last thing you take off before you go to bed?
Your feet off the floor.
Ah, that's a good one. Have you got a stack hat?
No.
You have got a stack. Well, you got a brand new. Look at that. Isn't that fabulous? Good on you, sweetheart. Okay, Dr. Timothy. Have you got it? This is Dr. Timothy. See, the kids come into Young Talent Time. They're all dressed up. He's got his name there. So, Timothy, tell us your giggle. Where you go?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Jenny and his underwear.
What did you say? Did you hear what he said? Could you say, what did he say?
Daddy in his underwear.
Daddy in his underwear. Oh, well, that's cute. Well, he must have been sick. He was in to have a checkup, wasn't he, Timothy? Well done. Okay. What's yours, sweetheart?
Why can't a car play football?
Why can't a cow play football? A car. Why can't a car play football?
Because it's only got one boot.
That's a clever one. There's a stack hat for you. We got any more giggles? We got another one here. What's your name, young man?
Glenn.
Oh, here's Glenn. Okay. Give everybody a look at your smiling face, Glenn. Look at that smile, will you? What a beauty. And what's your giggle, Glenn?
Why did a boy bring a ruler to bed?
What? Why did a boy bring a ruler to bed?
See how long he slept for.
Ah, that's a good one. Okay, now it's time for us to introduce a special guest. This is especially for all the little boys and girls. A lot of laughs. Would you welcome Dotto the Clown? Here he comes.
I'm going to make you all a little puppy dog out of one of these sausage balloons. Oh, look at this one. This is going to be a nice little blue puppy dog. There we go. I might give this a little girl over there. That's right, a big nice smile. Give her a big clap, boys and girls. I'll make you all a giraffe. Have giraffes got nice long, long necks, have they? Have giraffes got nice long, long necks, boys and girls? Here we go, a giraffe with a nice long, long neck. Woof, woof. What is it? It's a giraffe. Here we go, the little girl just over there. There she is. I'll make it one more. Oh, I know. If anybody guesses what this one is, you can have it. So if you think you know what it is, yell it out and you can have it. Oh, this is a nice one. Yes, it's going to be a puppy dog, but what type of puppy dog? Yes, somebody said a pink puppy dog. That's right, but what breed of puppy dog? Whoa, 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 never mind. I've got one more over here. Here we go. Oh! Oh. Aha, what colour is this one? That's right. Who said a blue puppy dog? They're at it again. No. I think he's going to be a little mouse. That's right. Oh, look at this one, a little mouse. No, it's not going to be a mouse. Yes, he is, a mouse. No, not a mouse. I don't know what this one's going to be, boys and girls. If you think you know, yell it out and tell me. Oh, a little poodle. Hand up, who wants my poodle? Oh, a little girl over here. Would you like me to make you all a nice big bunny rabbit?
Yeah.
Has rabbits got nice long ears, have they, boys and girls?
Yeah.
Here we go. Oh, I can't make a bunny rabbit out of one of these. It's not very long. Yes, I can. I'll wave my magic wand, say the magic words, and turn it into a bunny rabbit. I wonder what would happen if all the boys and girls said the magic words. That's a good idea. I'll place them over there. I'll say the magic words, wave my magic wand. Everyone together say dangalooey.
Dangalooey.
Muck-a-tie-tie. Who said the wrong magic words and made my magic wand disappear? Oh, what am I going to do, boys and girls? I haven't got a magic wand. I can't do any magic tricks without a magic wand. It won't work, I'll show you. Dangalooey muck-a-tie-tie, show the boys and girls a bunny rabbit. Oh! Oh! That's Whitey the rabbit. Say hello, Whitey.
Hello, Whitey.
Oh, there he is. A push bike.
Thank you.
look at these boys. Will you stand up, boys, and show everybody? Look, they're all Martians. Isn't that great? And they've got their names written on the front, so I don't need to introduce them. They're all from the one family?
Two families.
What are the names of the families?
The families, Shreve and Box.
Shreve and Box. These are the Shreve and the Box boys. Give them a big round of applause. Can you sit down now, boys? I went through a lot of trouble even with their microphones. And listen, here, you can all practice to be on Young Talent Time with your Young Talent Time microphones. The thing is, there's two families. That's for the two families. Hey, are you a Shreve or a Box?
I'm a Shreve. Hey,
what were you doing back in 1979?
1979. Coming
Queensland. From
Queensland? Yes.
Well, we're going to take a little journey back to 1979 and have a look at some interesting things, including in 1979, there was the release of the very first Commodore car. Now, have a look at this. 1979.
In our early motoring days, car engines and the oils protecting them were pretty crude. As engines improved, Shell improved oil. Everybody tells me that it's cool to be a cat, cool for cats.
When you work up a big Aussie first, slam down a solo.
Yellow brick road, come and wander down the yellow brick road. You will wonder as the wonders unfold and the stories are told down the yellow brick road.
Taking over the ACTU presidency in January 1970, many people now expect him to finish as Prime Minister.
Take a look at my girlfriend. She's the only one I got. Not much of a girlfriend. I never seem to get along.
Well, what's on the agenda for today?
The usual. Study.
Don't sound so cheerful. At least it's not the laundry.
The rec room's not exactly the National Library.
No, the laundry's not exactly Menzies Hotel either.
Well, who's going to be first to make him feel at home?
Welcome to both brothers, Mr.
Humphreys. Wilberforce Claiborne Humphreys.
Welcome to Australia, Mr. Humphreys. I'm Mr. Dunkley. This is my floor and I'm very proud of it.
Yes, it's got a nice shine on it. What sort of polish do you want?
That was the last two was Tina, Rena and Johnny Bowles, and there was Stephen Zammit,
yep,
and Debbie and Karen and all those. Just wonderful. Okay, right now it's time to move along with some closing music and you're going to love it. Here comes the Pink Cadillac with the Young Talent Team.
Baby, you know you're the
I'm just absolutely... Yeah, Kip, find your way, guys. That's great. That was terrific. Weren't that good?
Yeah.
That's great. And listen, Greg's the birthday boy this week. He's 16 years old. Wish him a happy birthday, everybody. And don't forget to join us next week for Young Talent Time, because it's Mark's last show before he leaves us to go to Neighbours, and that'll be a big night, won't it? We're all looking forward to it, and we're going to have a very special night, so join us next week for that. And of course, a lot of fun on Young Talent Time, because it's a just-for-fun show, so we'll be having a lot of laughs and all that sort of stuff, okay? It was a nice one. Welcome, Jamie. You got that one out of the way, didn't you?
Yeah.
And we'll be seeing lots of Jamie over the next few years. And great dancing in the closing numbers too. Thank you, Gillian. It was just terrific. And remember, I'll always... Good night, beautiful Natalie.
Good night.
Be true. Good night, Joey. Good night, Mrs. Joey. Courtney, sorry. And there I lie. Good night, Ricky. I'll ride home. Good night, Mark, and see you next week, eh?
Good night, yes.
And oh, good night, Ronnie, and I'll send all my loving and good night, Jamie Churchill. Yeah. Answer those letters when they come in, won't you? And on behalf of our wonderful sponsors, McDonald's, I hope you've enjoyed the show, and good night, everybody.
There's a brand new lineup weekdays on Channel 10, starting at 5 with the Munsters. Be first with the news, Eyewitness News, now 5:30. At 6:30 it's Neighbours, then at 7, Perfect Match. A great lineup, weekdays on Perth's new Channel 10.
Young Talent Time is a Television House production for Network 10 Australia. Gavin Wood speaking.
Tonight's Young Talent Time was brought to you by McDonald's Family Restaurants.